So as of right now, we are going to take a little look inside the Dallas ISD school board meeting that is streaming online. Trustees are deciding in this meeting here whether they want to push back the start of the school year, and that's honestly just the start of what they're discussing. Robbie Owens is joining us live now with our top story at 6 o'clock to bring us up to speed on what we know as of right now.
Well, Doug, I've been listening in on that meeting online as well. And while we expected to hear from parents, and there have been a couple, the vast majority of speakers this afternoon and the ones expressing the most grave concerns were the teachers.
Dallas Board trustees gathered in person, mask on, to begin the difficult task of managing learning in the midst of a pandemic.
But we want to do so in a way that respects the health and safety of students, staff, and the broader Dallas community. I do not want to attend any funerals for my students or my colleagues.
During the virtual public comment section, teacher after teacher implored the trustees to consider the danger, saying nothing has changed since schools were shuttered in March. These are educators, after all, so it shouldn't have come as a surprise when one had done the deadly math.
Using the infection and fatality rates for children given by the CDC, and applying this to the enrollment from last year, as of yesterday, that would mean about 8,000 students sick and at least 8 children dead in less than 6 months. I wonder which students will suffer or die if we reopen too soon.
Even prior to the meeting, teachers, parents, and those who fill both roles say the district's back-to-school plan needs more details.
I guess I'm looking for more direct or an explicit, maybe, breakdown of what a day in the life of a elementary student, or because I am a teacher, or the day of the life of a high school student from start to finish. What does that look like? How will they eat lunch? Where will they eat lunch? Passing periods.
And although not the issue on the agenda, speaker after speaker urging leaders to pass on returning to campus in the middle of a pandemic.
I agree with and support the teachers. There seems to be quite a consensus among them. So DISD, I would please consider yourselves accountable for the risks that you're asking them to take.
Now, parents and teachers today expressing concern about the inability of young kids to physical distance. They question whether the district would be able to provide enough supplies, pointing out that routinely parents are asked to provide things like tissue and hand sanitizer, and that's when those things were in big supply and easy to come by. But bottom line, both state leaders and local leaders have promised parents the option of either virtual or classroom instruction, and it will be teachers who are asked to deliver on that promise. Reporting live, I'm Robbie Owens. Back to you.